I stop by to tell you, my brother and my sister.
Yes, sir. Take your time, Pastor.
I'm so glad that I'm leaving on time. And Charles, I get up on time. And I go to bed. I don't know about on time on that. But I can't use that. But at least I go to bed and time bring me up. Oh, Lord. Some of y'all go to bed on time. I stop by to tell you today. Time will bring a change in your life. And I remember back a few years ago, I could jump up all around this altar, all around the pulpit, and now my step got shorter, and I can't jump like I used to jump, and I don't take no chance by jumping now. But I remember them days. It's good to cherry the days that you used to be able to jump. My step got slower, but one thing I know, I'm on my way to a better place, and that is the kingdom of God. I tell you, I stop by to tell you, my brother and my sister, time will bring a change in your life. All you got to do is just live on these beautiful children here today. They can run all around this church and not get tired, but let them keep on living.
Woo! Good job.
Yes, sir.
That's all, God.
Yes, sir.
I know you still can run.
Time will bring a change. Y'all know anything about Arthur Rouse? Oh, I will come in your life. Change your course and change your step. Change how you go. I'm talking about time, y'all. I wish I had a little time to preach it. But I stop by to tell you, church, hold on. You got something to hold on. You got the word. It always will be there with you, no matter what time zone you're in. All you got to do is pick up the word of God, and God will refresh your mind. God will change your course. God will.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
One day in time, Jesus went to the cross, died out there on Calvary in the right time, and then in the time zone, they put him down in a borrowed tomb. In the time zone, I heard his word, the tomb couldn't hold him.
Just couldn't hold him, child.
He got up with all power on the third day. That's the time zone. On the third day, he rose, I tell ya. He rose with all power. All power in his heavenly hand.
He got up. Just couldn't hold it.
The grave couldn't hold it.
No, sir.
In time, y'all, the blind man couldn't see. But God touched his eyes. Eyes came open. In time, later they put him in the tomb. Four long days. I think that's right. Isn't that right? Four long days. The Bible said that the he began to start thinking.
Yes,
that's
sir.
What I'm talking about.
Yes,
that's in there. You
yes,
know.
Sir.
But I heard Martha say, If you had been there, yeah, my brother wouldn't die. Well, she forgot about child Jesus is the resurrection, yeah, of life. Yeah. She forgot about he is eternal life.
Yes,
he is life himself. But he went on down to the grave and he just said a few words, mother.
Yeah.
Come forth, Lazarus.
Yes,
and Lazarus came forth.
Yes,
don't tell me what God can't do, y'all.
Yes.
There's nothing impossible that God can't do. He can raise you up out of your sick bed. I'm talking about God. He can move cancer from your body. He can straighten your heart out. He can straighten your mind out, baby. Can he do it, D?
Yeah.
D was sick, but God healed him.
Yeah.
And he didn't have mind problems. But D was blessed through God. Sister Hudson is healed.
Oh, yeah.
By his grace. I'm going by his grace, y'all.
Yes.
Oh, Lord. Look at Stephen. Steve was in the hospital for 88 days. But God brought him out. I'm talking about God, y'all. I'm talking about nobody else. God brought him out. God will bring you out. Whatever the condition.
That's right.
Y'all might know it. And I hope you don't mind telling me saying it. That's once in a lifetime that Sister Hampton was sick. Sister Nicole back then. But God brought her out. I'm talking about God, y'all. God healed a body.
Yes, yes, yes.
Let me know about God.
Yes, sir.
That's right. A
few years back, that's about 18 years. Mother Bullock had heart problems. But God healed a body. Sister Thomas, Minister Thomas,
yes,
sick a few days ago.
Yes.
But look what God did for her.
Yes.
She wasn't able to be here last Sunday.
Yes.
But look how God in time.
Yes.
So when you, my child, you weren't able to be here. But I guarantee you, through my mercy and my kindness,
yes,
you'll be right here on the fifth Sunday.
Yes.
Woo.
Yes.
That's God, y'all. Mother Krista, God is healing her right now.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I'm telling y'all what I know. God is healing her right now.
Yes,
because God is everywhere at the same time.
Yes.
He's omnipotent, omnipresent.
Yes.
He happened on me,
yes,
beginning in the end.
Yes.
I heard one writer said, just like fire shut up in my bone. He's a wheel in the middle of a wheel.
Right.
I'm talking about Jesus, y'all.
Yeah,
yeah, Lord. I'm talking about how good God is,
yeah, yeah,
in time.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to tell y'all another secret y'all didn't know. Some of y'all didn't know it. I know another great man that is here today by the name of Charles Williams. A few years back, we all had a program for him. Charles thought that he was leaving the earth. Y'all didn't hear me, did you? I hope you don't mind me saying. But look at him now, y'all. Look what God has done for him. God healed his body. God healed. Charles Bradley almost could walk in here that night. God healed him.
Praise God.
He's able, mother.
Praise God.
God healed
him. Thank you, Jesus.
Huh?
You can do it.
It ain't time. It's a night. He told me 12 miles. It ain't time right now. Yes!
All right.
Deacon Pippen was healed.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
God bless Brother Walt.
That's right.
He got a testimony.
Yes, he did.
He's on internet.
Yeah.
He made the jet paper. and it's still in record.
That's right.
You know, before I did that, I didn't know the Lord, but he knew me.
He knows you. He saved you.